Welcome back to Canoe Live. Have you ever wanted to take a trip across the Caribbean, New Orleans, Rio, Europe, or even Asia? Well, now you can, and in just 3 days. This weekend, you'll get a chance to soak up the magic of Carnivalissima, an international carnival packed with loads of rhythm and spice, rumba lessons, stilt dancing, as well as an opening night masquerade ball. Let's take a look. Well, if you're a fan of comedy, you're going to enjoy my next guest. The Israeli-Palestinian comedy tour make their debut in Canada with their first performance in Toronto. With a mission to resolve the Middle East conflict through comedy, the comics also promise to make us laugh in the face of politics, religion, and culture. Joe, I know you've traveled all around the world. What types of sounds and cultural influences did you pick up along your journey and fuse into your own style of music?
Well, I think because I was born in Chile from a diplomat family. I left Chile for almost 18 years, so I lived in so many different places.
What an honor it must have been for you to compose the music for the Dalai Lama during his visit to Chile.
Indeed.
I can't even imagine. What was that experience like for you?
Indeed, that was the second time. Every time I have an invitation from the Dalai Lama and from my Buddhist brothers.
Okay, I'm dying to ask you this. Your name is now officially Michelle Montano HD. And you claim to be the first human being to go HD.
In the universe.
So what?
High def, definitely
well,
high.
Well, I was going to ask you, what does this mean? What is it?
You know, I mean, just the whole concept of HD. Everybody's going HD, HD radio, HD TV, HD drinks. You know, I thought that I would be the first human to be far from fuzzy, really clear. I am going to transmit my message a lot clearer now.
So if you've got an appetite and want to try out a new cuisine, you can check out Caju at 922 Queen Street West for a taste of Brazil. And if you tried some amazing cultural cuisine or restaurant lately, send us your reviews at sendit@canoelive.ca. We're going to take a break right now, but I'll be back with more Canoe Live. And here you go. Bon appetit.
Cheers.
But our next guest is definitely adventurous with food. In fact, he's been tagged the Indiana Jones of the food world. Dr. Massimo Maconi embarked on a cultural journey that looked into, let's just say, strange delicacies from different parts of the world. You don't want to know what this is, actually. Can you explain this?
Well, just like we have Kopi Luwak coffee that came out of the back end of an animal, yeah. This happened in Indonesia, but in another part of the world, in Morocco, they have the argan nut, which is eaten by a goat that climbs into the tree,
okay.
And you produce this oil from it.
Okay, so once again, the goat eats this, and then it excretes it,
exactly.
And it's turned into this oil.
And the ladies at the co-op will produce the oil. So from each tree, you get about a liter of oil.
So what do we use this oil in?
It's usually used on salads.
The Mutadi International Drumming Festival will kick off this Saturday in its own fashion, with thousands of people beating a path to Queen's Park in celebration of one of the world's oldest and most universal instruments, the drum. The Mutadi Drumming Festival is also a part of the Luminato Festival, which highlights Toronto's culture and diversity in the arts. Before you leave, do you think you can, you know, drum us into the break?
I would like you to try some.
Oh, okay, let's go for it, okay? We're back with more of Canoe Live right after the break. Let's hear you do some. Wow. First of all, Bon Jovi, and what a song. Did you watch it?
I saw it.
Okay.
Because my wife made me watch it.
It was unbelievable.
No, but it's an 80s country rock song, and the beatboxing had no place in it.
No, but that's why it was so interesting is that he made it his own. It's so authentic. Anybody could just go up there and sing it, but this guy brought a completely different style to it. I was impressed.
He can have it. He butchered a song I don't even like.
Oh, I totally disagree.
Okay, now what I want to know about is, did you happen to watch the Miss Universe pageant last night?
Of course. I'm going to watch the Miss Universe pageant.
And
hello.
You say that because you were Miss Canada and
yes.
You competed in Miss Universe. So.
Yeah, so it's a family tradition.
So what did you make of this, Rachel Smith, when she was representing the U.S. and she fell? And a lot of people thought, well, that's ridiculous. All she had to do was walk and she fell.
But it's not really about that. What we don't see is the interview process, and we're not going to get into that because that's a whole show in itself. But, I mean, I think that the audience was really impressed with her just getting up. I think it sort of sent a message and everyone was like cheering on, you know, cheering on the underdog kind of thing.
And this is cat poop coffee from Indonesia. The cats eat the coffee beans, and then they poop it out, and then they turn it into the most expensive coffee
exactly.
In the world.
Exactly.
You didn't try it then, but you're going to try it now.
Yeah,
right?
I have a deal for you. If you really try it, I'll try it. But
okay.
You have to. You can't pretend.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So,
ready?
1, 2, 3. It's good.
Wow, you can taste
I can't believe I actually tasted it.
You can only touch one point. point on the screen at a time. This one you can touch however much you want. You can just molest the whole thing.
How much is this thing going to cost, Dave? Because I'm assuming you can't pick it up from the brick or
something
like that.
No, I think right now it's in like the testing stages, between $5,000 and $10,000.
What? $5,000 and $10,000?
Not even Bill Gates can afford it.
No one's putting a coffee on that table.